I'm sure you have seen heat distortion effects that show up in really hot areas. Here we'll make that effect, and then upgrade it with a little trick to give us more control and fix some common problems. First, we are going to need a plane where our effect will take place. Add a mesh instance 3D node and create a vertical plane with it. Make it very big so that it can cover the whole horizon. And let's position it at the far end of our desert scene. Open the Geometry tab and let's create a new shader material. Click to expand it and create a new shader. Name it Heat Haze and hit Create. And then click on the shader name to open it. We are going to use the shader to distort everything that is behind this plane, using the same technique as screen space reflections, by getting a copy of the screen. To get the screen texture, we declare a uniform sample 2D named Screen Texture, and then use the Hint Screen Texture flag that will make Godot give us a rendered image of the screen. If we set our albedo using the screen UV and this texture now, our plane will seemingly disappear. But that's not what's happening here. We are essentially coloring our plane the same color of the screen, which will make it appear transparent. And you might have noticed a small discoloration. That is because our plane is receiving lights on top of the screen image. We can fix this by setting the render mode flag to unshaded to make our plane ignore all lights. If your environment uses fog, this will also affect the shader, so we also need to set the fog disabled flag. Then we can shift the screen texture by changing the UV. And that's what we are going to use to distort our image. To make the distortion happen, we are going to need a noise map. So we declare another uniform sample 2D for our noise texture. And on the right, inside our shader parameters, create a new noise texture 2D. Expand it and create a new fast noise light. This will generate our noise map texture. You can customize your noise to adjust the distortion effect you want. But the important setting here is that we check seamless to make the image loop correctly. Now let's put that noise to work. We can get a random noise value by sampling the noise texture and getting the red channel. And we are going to use that noise value to shift our screen UV. If we multiply this by a small value, we can see the results better. To give it some movement, we can use the time variable on our noise UV and multiply it by something smaller to slow down the effect. Now let's convert those small values into something that we can adjust. Declare a float speed value for our distortion speed, and using hint range and passing the min and max values to make a slider appear in our shader parameters for us to adjust later. And create a strength value that will control the distortion power. Then replace our numbers for these variables. Next, we need to center our distortion effect. As of now, it is shifted to the top left. That is because we are adding our noise values to the screen UV. The noise value goes from 0 to 1 and then are multiplied by our strength. So to center the effect, we need to subtract it by half the value of the max noise value possible. We can do that by reducing the final value by half the strength. Now we can adjust the values in our shader parameters and try to find something that feels right. Finally, let's add a direction vector too, so we can better control our effect. We get our distortion as the vector 2 of the noise multiplied by the direction. And use that to shift the screen UV now. Remembering to also multiply our direction to center the effect. Now we can use the direction variable to control how it waves around, making it move more horizontally or vertically. And that's the basic distortion effect done. But here's a common problem with these types of effects. If your distortion is subtle enough, you might not notice, so let's ramp it up. The border of the effect in front of the shader are spilling over from behind. That's because the shader doesn't really know what's behind the plane. It is only distorting the visible screen, so it spills the object in front sometimes. We are going to fix this by using a more advanced trick with Godot's sub-viewport nodes, making it only render the dunes behind the shader and distortion that instead of the screen. First, let's create a new sub-viewport node and add a camera to it. Subviewports will render the active camera inside them into textures. Selecting a node will show up a preview of that image. We are going to use it in place of our screen, so we need to make it the same size as our game's window. Inside our background desert scene, select the mesh, change the visual instance 3D layer to only the layer 2. And on the camera inside our subviewport, we are going to change its cool mask to 2 as well. This will make it render only the meshes in that layer, the dunes we just set up. Looking at the subviewport preview image now, we'll only show the dunes. Next step, we need to synchronize our cameras, to make sure they are always rendering the same thing. Select our main game camera, add a remote transform node, and link it to the camera inside the subviewport to make their transforms the same. Now both of our cameras will be in sync, and the subviewport camera will follow the game's main camera. Next, we are going to replace our screen texture, so open the shader again. The little spill color at the top can be fixed by adding the repeat disabled flag. And let's remove the hint screen texture now so we can set up the screen texture inside our shader parameters. Add a new viewport texture. If you get this error, you'll need to make sure your shader is local to the scene, as we are linking it to another node. Inside resource, enable local to scene. And let's try again. Selecting our subviewport. It is difficult to see here, but it's actually working. But we need to fix those colors. Go to the subviewport. In the rendering tab, enable HDR 2D. We can now see something, but it's not quite right yet. Besides the color, the reason that is because the subviewport is seeing things from our camera's perspective, so we need to see what our camera sees to make it look right. And the color problem is because the environment tone map and adjustment settings are messing things up. To fix this, we are going to need to copy our environment, go to our viewport camera, and paste that environment there. Make it unique, and reset the tone map and adjustment settings there, if you have them. Now our color should finally look right, and we can see it working inside our game. You might need to change the rendering settings inside the subviewport, and add a bit of anti-aliasing to remove the pixelated lines. You can make your editor's camera sync with the subviewport, so we can see the results inside our editor. To do that, create a simple tool script in the subviewport camera. We use the engine.isEditorHint to make it run only when inside the editor, and set its transform to the editor's camera. We can get that camera with editorInterface.getEditorViewport3D.getCamera3D. And as this is a tool script, make sure to reload the scene to make the changes work. Now we can rotate around and see the effects inside the editor too. Originally, I only had the distortion happening to the dunes outside the play area, so I didn't notice this at first. But if you have other objects behind the shader, they also need to be in the visual layer that is rendered by the subviewport. So you might need some script that changes the visual layer of objects when they get behind the shader. And finally, we can change our shader from a plane to a dome. That way it will cover the entire background without gaps. Let's duplicate our shader and hide the original. Reset the mesh and create a sphere, a very big sphere, and position it around the player. Disable cast shadows, and inside our shader, let's add a co-disabled render flag, so we can see the inside of our sphere. And now we have our shader affecting everything around the player. And that's it! You can make use of a simple distort shader, or use the subviewport trick we made to distort only the backgrounds of your world, or make it fall around the player, distorting faraway objects. I hope this video helps, and until next time.